We are joined, as ever, by the senator and also by the senator's tia Sonia. Is my Spanish is not very good, but I think that was about right. Aunt Sonia.
That is correct.
Thank you. This is, in a few days, going to be the 58th anniversary of your fleeing the communist regime in Cuba.
That is correct, sir.
And yet we've got the leader of the Democratic Party nomination process is praising the Fidel Castro regime. I think we have the clip.
Very opposed to the authoritarian nature of Cuba. But, you know, you got, it's unfair to simply say everything is bad. You know, when Fidel Castro came into office, you know what he did? He had a massive literacy program. Is that a bad thing?
Listen, Bernie has spent his entire life, his entire career, praising communist dictators. But this week, his latest ode to Fidel Castro, frankly, just pissed me off. And this is not a joke. This guy is the front runner for the Democratic nomination to be president. And he sings the praises of Castro and Cuban communism. My dad fled Cuba in 57. My tia Sonia was still there. She was a kid. And so she saw the Cuban Revolution firsthand, and she ended up fighting against Castro. So tia, if you would, I just want you, first of all, tell me what it was like to be in Cuba when the revolution happened, when Castro took over.
Actually, it was a lot of people were happy because finally somebody was coming in that was praising, we're going to give you a chance to change your hope. We're going to change things around. Everybody was going to have whatever they want to. The poor will never be poor. The rich continue to have money. And everybody will be the same. In reality, yes, everybody went the same, but everybody was poor. Everybody went down. Everybody got paid the same amount of money. There was no difference between the poor and the rich. Everybody lost
everything. It's not that everyone was rich. Everyone was poor and suffering and miserable.
And everybody was miserable. Everybody was miserable. What Bernie is saying is a bunch of garbage.
So you're there. You're a teenager. How old were you?
Probably 16, 15.
Okay, so you're seeing this. You're a teenage girl.
Right.
You see what's happening. You see Castro begin executing people.
Yeah, persecuting people. Nobody could talk. Nobody could say anything. They actually, he trained the people to even be against the family. The sons against the father. The daughters against the family.
So how did he do that?
By indoctrinating these people, by telling we're going to give you this and that and the other, and it's all going to be free, but you got to tell us what's going on in your house, who talk against the government. So everything was persecuting one another, especially the older people, that actually we live a good life before in Cuba. It was beautiful.
What do people face in terms of their friends and neighbors and family spying on them
for
the government?
You have people in each block, there is somebody that is responsible to keep an eye on you in your house.
So there's a tattletale.
An individual,
there's a spy on every block.
In every block. And they tell you, you keep an eye on every neighbor of this block. So
and what sort of things are they watching for?
They're watching for everything. If you bring anything, I'm going from United States to Cuba, and there's somebody coming in. So we need to watch that house in case they go out and sell in the black market or they do something with what you brought in. So there's somebody's always keeping an eye on you and try to report you. A good thing that happened to something that happened to me that is very interesting. One of the trips that I went back to Cuba, I wanted to take the kids, some of the kids from there, to go fishing. I love fishing. So I went in and tried to rent a boat, and they told me, we can't. We don't rent boats to Cuban people. And I said, you may leave. And I said, look, I have a passport. I have a flight leaving on Friday. I already left. So I'm coming in to take my family on a boat ride. We can't give it to you. We can't rent you a boat. You're Cuban. So
because they're so afraid.
By the way,
they
Michael,
know
if you go there, you can rent a boat.
You can
as
rent
an American.
A boat.
Right.
She can't rent a boat because she's Cuban, even though she's an American citizen now.
Yes, you're Cuban. So you can't do it. There was a boat in the river that my niece wanted to go in. And when we get in to ride the boat with the rest of the people, they said, you all cannot get in. You all are Cuban. And I said, but we're paying with the same money that they're paying. Well, I'm sorry. You can't come in. You're not from another country. You're Cuban, and Cuban people are not allowed.
They're not allowed to leave.
No,
because they
know
if they were allowed to leave, they'd all leave. Sonia, how quickly after, as you say, you know, people liked Castro initially. He was promising them the world. How quickly did it turn? I mean, how quickly did it turn?
It turned right away.
It did.
Right away. He immediately starts saying the policies that he wanted to do. He was going to take things away from the rich. He was going to take things away from the people to give to others. He was to actually take money from you and give it to the poor. So on the other side, I make my money. I work for what I have. My father worked hard to be where he was. My mother was a great school teacher. She was really was proud of what she was doing. My mother itself was told, did she have to teach at the school a different kind of curriculum? She was told she needed to teach about the revolution, Castro, the regime, the things that needed to happen. My mother had to actually pretend that she was losing her mind, and she was dismissed immediately.